Hello everybody, this is Dark Momoto, and welcome back to Stories, the Path of Destiny. I messed up my own name right there, but you know what? I'm just gonna keep going. So, last time, we finished and we got the gourd, and we went to the frogs.
No, that was only the last part.
The last truly part, we went to the frogs to tell us that the gourd was protecting us from the evil stone from the Dark Influence, like it says, right? Of course, that's what I read. Haha, I may sound smart, but I'm just reading from here. Haha. Alright, so a piece, yes, that almost makes sense. So if we go here, we can get peace. You know, final balance. But up below in the court did not sound reassuring. Maybe Renato could find peace real quick. Then go back into the fray to save Redden to the mountains he would need to go. But finding peace takes time, and the rebellion was running out of time. Renato had to focus on the mission. He had to save the rebellion while there was a rebellion to save. To the railways now. Peace, no, the rebellion depended on it. Here's the thing. I think this is the last part for like another ending, maybe. But if I get peace, maybe everything just go poof, screwed. Like, it's the end. If I go here, I could die again. Cause like, maybe I need, it will overload, maybe it will destroy my hand or blow up in my face. So I'm gonna end it in a good note. By going.
The one thing he understood from all the Toad arguments, maybe the stone did not feed on blood or souls or rage. It fed on empathy. It fed on the pain he felt when he put an end to another being's existence. Even if that other being was a raven intent on killing him,
maybe
if he could find peace, then he could use the power of the Ibla Stone without being taken over by its evil, the mountains. He would go to the mountains. He could find peace there.
Why did I get the chance I screw up? I made a boo-boo, didn't I? I made a big boo-boo. I screwed up. Save me. The game's like, hey, you screw up. You made a big boo-boo.
Unfortunately, the mountains were not empty. There were ravens everywhere. No matter. He had to fight, yes, but he didn't have to be angry.
It's
parry,
the little thing.
Dodge, slash, and breathe. Yes, focus on the rhythm, the dance of it. Not on the blood or the raven's caw as they died. Ah, it was working. He wasn't feeling those dark jolts of eldritch energy. He wasn't feeding the Ibla Stone.
Are you sure about that? I can power my. Yeah, I can power my. Also, a nice house around it.
More fire? Yes, please.
See, like, I can level up real quick. Oh, yeah, I forgot to waste ores. Okay, so. That's gonna take a while for me to get things. Oh, my nose is starting to be bad. Something I don't need, but I like it. Heavy creep. I like heavy stuff creep. Energy. Oh boy. Down. Going down.
Hoped his hook didn't break.
Mash it! Mouse! My teleport. I'm lazy. No, I don't need to go there. Let's go here. Yep. Oh, my bear! My bear! Oh, I can't breathe. Oh, man, I have something. Come here, boy. Oh, my nose is running right now, and it's bait. Well, you always have paper on it. Come here. Come here. I forgot I could throw people away. Like. I forgot that mechanic so much.
Nobody felt bad for littering, but these islands were short on trash cans.
I forgot I could throw poop. Since we're being off equipped. Right, left or right? But I have the eyes so I can explore down here.
I slow away!
Ooh, what's there?
I don't know, but let's find out. Hey, it's Dane DeBrake, and this thing happened. Welcome to Uncharted. Hey, stop. Oh, God. Yeah, teleport somewhere else. Yeah, I'll take it. I have no idea what this is gonna take.
This thing really needed a roof.
Oh god, I went somewhere different. Come here. Now, freezing people are gonna be cool.
The stone was still silent. His mind was his own. And his heart, too. He bore them no ill will, these ravens. They were doing their job. They were expressing their nature. Dance, whirl, parry, jab, and breathe.
And throw.
It was all so simple, wasn't it? But something was missing.
Well, I'm going.
Chest. He didn't feel truly at peace.
Chest.
Wait. Wasn't this near where Calaveras lived? The sage would help him figure it all out.
Where am I going? I missed so many chests. I missed a lot of stuff.
Take her or leave her. Sorry, it's best I could do.
Any idea why I have to be right? Like, any idea why I need to do this?
The Iblis Stone, silenced by the Sky Ripper's core, had given Renato enough power to challenge the Imperial fleet. But what Renato was seeking was inner peace. The rebellion was on the verge of extinction. Have to wait.
Play on the ground. This game is going like. Hi there, big papa. Yeah, like I said, I was gonna buy the soul by time. That's only half one, so. Whole steam. Right here is big boy.
At the end of the mountain path, he found the wise Calaveras in his workshop. Do fix souls or only artifacts? He asked the sage.
Does your soul need fixing?
Asked the sage. I've been killing a lot of ravens lately, he told the sage.
You're a fox,
said Calaveras.
To kill birds is part of your nature. Take joy in it. I mean, I might as well worry about eating flies. Would you like a fly?
It was true. That's what he had forgotten. The joy. Now he was ready for the final battle. The Farfarer cut through the clouds. The air had never felt so sweet since he was a child. There it was, the dreaded Imperial fleet. He could smell wet hemp ropes ahead, wood and tar, and ravens. Even the fleet smelt good, somehow. He was ready. He was ready.
I have a... I bet if anybody's... He said he was ready. I'm like... I like how the loading screen becomes bigger. The dots become smaller and bigger. Once it's done. Alright, we're going to battle.
Renato had it all squared away in his head.
Show him the
He would kill the Emperor. Isengrim III had begun well, but he had gone mad. He was trying to invoke the lost gods by means of dark, blasphemous rituals. That was a secret. But the victims had spoken to Renato. The ghosts had spoken. No. No anger. Renato could not afford anger. It was empowering the crystal in his sword. That made him stronger, but it clouded his mind. He would not be a hero. A hero strives. Renato would just be one with everything. The Emperor would die, and the wheel would turn, and all would be restored without rancor, without sorrow, without pain.
Is this the same part of last time? Now we can kill the Emperor. Like, is this the same part as last time?
He'd once been a pirate captain. He used hooks to get around his ship. Oh, what was his name again?
Captain Hook. What's up, fool? Alright, so I can touch him. I can break him and touch him and then but that's what I want. Okay, is this the last one? I think it is. Whoa! Well, the game's having a bit of a problem with the load. Yeah, this is the same one as last time. So, what's it's gonna, oh, it's gonna be the end? They're gonna keep adding new enemies and enemies till. Okay. I'm okay with it. Oh, that was four. Here we can sell any more boxes.
Killer! Kill the rebel!
Raven.
Oh god, I forgot about the bomb. There you go. Almost level up. No, can I go back? No, I can't. Oh, damn it. I missed that. Maybe I can now? Can I go back? No. Ugh, I missed the door.
Oops. Thought Renato.
Yep. Save it, live! Where you going, big boy? Where you going, big boy? Level. And to get some energy. And more ships.
What did you do if one of these platforms stalled?
Turn around. Oh, now I can break it, fool. Oh, I should have. What's up, bro? What's up?
The more he thought about it, and he had so much more time to think about it now that he was not worrying about the battle.
Now,
killing the Emperor would not change anything. Another would take his place. Perhaps Zenobia. Perhaps the Speaker of the Rebel Council, and power would corrupt them too, and death would make grief. Grief would lead to hatred. No, he must lead by example. Reject the violence. Reject the desire to create violence. But how?
I have no idea. I'm trying to hold contact. But that report has like many body problems. Like my nose, and I want to hold the burbs. I'm like,
Hey, who do I have to kill to get a drink around here? You? Okay.
I am not doing good just now. Yeah, I need a heal. I wish the L1 and R1 could change my swords instead of my weapons, because I have to move and do this at the same time. Oh boy. I'm not even in the last part of the boat. But I am in the boat. Not a boat. It's ship. Ship boat. Whatever. No, this is the last one. Because I remember finding the ravens right over there. We'd get it past.
Soon he'd confront the Emperor.
Yeah, it's right here.
Funny that this whole war had come about because the Emperor feared death.
No,
now
right
he's coming for him. There was some sort of lesson there, wasn't there?
That was the last battle, the big battle. Oh wait, you have some special need to do Heiki powers, didn't you? Enchantments can buff and heal enemies. Buff ravens are dangerous. So I'm going after you, AS first. Every time I choose to have his sword, so it's like, gotta see how this game's gonna be. I feel like when the true ending comes and I go over there, it's gonna be a ton of monsters right here with all the kinds of combos.
Finally, he came to the Emperor's ship. The path behind him was strewn with dead ravens. The path to enlightenment. His mistake, he realized, was trying to change the world. The world would spin and the wheel would revolve whether he strove against it or not. What he had to do was nothing.
What?
He had attained enlightenment. He sat down, adopted a full lotus position, and began to meditate. And all around him, the warriors stopped fighting too. They knew. They could feel his enlightenment. They gave up fighting, dropped their weapons, and became his disciples. No, just kidding. The nearest raven stabbed him with a sword and then chopped off his head.
I might not have thought this through properly. Thought Renardo's head as it rolled around the deck and died.
Can't even save it. Like I said, save
it. Renardo stared at the book. He was still alive, again, and still only flying away from burning Ubar. Had he lived that adventure, or only dreamt it? Had he really died? It felt so real, not like a dream at all. And he'd lost again. Oh, he hated that. But he had made different choices, and he'd lost in a different way. It was the book, wasn't it? Oracles showed you your destiny. But this was showing him different ways he could die miserably. Thanks a bunch, book, he thought. But these were destinies that he did not have to fulfill. But he'd learn another true thing. The Iblis Stone was evil. It would try to corrupt anyone who used it.
Alright, so what kind of new story completed, story 15, Return of the Hippie. What kind of hero are you? Hero who transcends being a hero to become one with everything. Blah, blah, blah. So I look another path. There are three skill locks. The stone corrupts anyone who uses it. So the endless moment and return to Hippie. The stone corrupts anyone who uses. Okay, so I'm missing two fruits for the true ending, I think.
But that meant there must be a destiny where he survived and won, right? Otherwise, what was the point? And with that, the book's pages fluttered back once more to the beginning, and the clouds parted over the Isles of Boreas. It was time to choose. The rebellion was in trouble.
Ravens
were scouting for the secret rebel base. They needed a game changer. Pieces of the Sky Ripper had surfaced. Or so a scholar in the mountains had told him. Surely the weapon that banished the lost gods could defeat the Emperor. Also, a temple had risen out of empty desert. The Iblis Stone was hidden
there.
Oh,
now he's like in the face.
It was a dangerous artifact. It could corrupt its user into a bloodthirsty monster. Maybe he could find a way to use it. To take its power without surrendering to its wickedness. And also, his old friend Lupino needed rescuing.
Lupino can, you know, stay.
Renato had a pretty strong suspicion that Lupino had betrayed the rebellion. But could Renato really leave an old friend to the Ravens?
So, the Iblis Stone was the one that made us evil, but the Sky Ripper was okay. Right? Yeah, the Iblis Stone, meaning this is bad, this is bad. This is the right one? Alright, so I'm gonna end it here because I am way over time. But yeah, next time we're gonna build the Sky Ripper. So, thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Please subscribe for more Santa content that I've done. And remember, have a nice day, nice evening, nice night. Bye.